let's start with the basic nutrients that fruit trees need. So we go to our garden centers and we see that there are fertilizers and they have NPK values. So is that all our fruit trees need? Tell me, what is NPK and what part of the diet is that for a fruit tree?
Okay, that's a good question. NPK, of course, stands for nitrogen, which is the N, P, which is phosphorus, and potassium, which is K. And that's why you see the NPK. Those are what we call macronutrients, among the macronutrients, and that's where most of our fertilizers are from. However, your next question about, there are, well, at least when I went to school, there were 16 essential nutrients that are needed. And one of the ways we learned how to remember them was a little memory trick where we had a saying goes and went, C, Hopkins Cafe, mighty good, clean, mob comes in. And
Okay. So C Hopkins Cafe. I love that. So C Hopkins, like Charlie Hopkins, something like that. So let's take us through Charlie Hopkins, his cafe. It's mighty clean, whatever. Tell me a little bit about that. How do you associate that with nutrients?
Okay. Basically what it is, if you write it out with the chemical symbols for those nutrients, that tells you what they are. And so the C is for carbon. We have Hopkins, which is in order, hydrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, potassium, nitrogen, and sulfur. And that's how you get to Hopkins. See, it's H-O-P-K-N-S. And then you have CAFE, which is, everybody knows how to spell that, C-A-F-E. Well, it stands, C-A stands for calcium, F-E stands for iron. So those are the other two. Then we get into the next one, mighty good. Well, that's magnesium, M-G. And then we have clean, which is represented by Cl, which is chlorine symbol. And then we have mob. Mob means M-O-B, and M-O is molybdenum, which is tough to say now. And then boron, which of course is the B on that. And comes in as kind of a alliteration, I guess you'd say. It's Cu, which is copper, Mn, which is manganese, not magnesium, but manganese. And the last one is zinc, Zn.
So we were talking about how fruit trees' needs change throughout the growing season. So I thought we would go season by season. And I want to start with winter. What is happening to our fruit trees in the winter and what nutritional needs do they have then?
Okay, right now, they're like all bears are trying to hibernate. They're essentially trying to, you know, there's a lot of small microscopic things that are going. The flower buds are still developing. They're actually going through a period of enzymatic changes that they are developing flowers or continue to develop slowly but surely. And but they're basically resting right now. They're not really not absorbing anything because we normally have to have temperatures. Soil temperatures need to be above 50 degrees Fahrenheit for them to absorb nutrients. So most of the soils are probably not there. And so they're not getting much absorption. Plus there's no leaf to pull the nutrients up. So right now, just like us, kind of sitting back and trying to keep warm.
So the first time you're fertilizing during the year is going to be 4 to 6 weeks before bloom time. That's your first session. The tree itself is still hibernating, but what you're hoping for is for the nutrients to break down and become accessible to the tree, right?
Correct.
So what kind of fertilizers or what kind of nutrients are you, would a homeowner or somebody else use at that time of year?
This time of year, they're probably most looking at things like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, maybe calcium. They may need to adjust the soil pH, maybe some magnesium if they have magnesium deficiency. But basically what we're looking at is what we call the macronutrients, the ones that are needed in the greatest amount of supply.
So would you go to your garden center and get one of your, you know, fertilizers with an NPK number or would you mulch your tree with compost? What are the options at that point?
Okay, you can do all those. But basically what we're talking about is, you know, if you're going to use inorganic fertilizer, which is a salt type thing, that's where you go. You probably go get nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. You could need some, as I said, may need some lime, calcium. I can put that on. if you're going to use compost or organic matter type of fertilizer, then that also needs to go on early. And that's because it now needs to be absorbed down into the soil. It needs to be transformed, and then it'll be available for the roots to take up into the tree.
So in springtime and summertime, what are the different nutritional needs that your fruit tree may have? Are there certain nutrients in particular that they'll need?
Yeah, you know, of course, the real critical point, the reason we're growing fruit trees is we want to have fruit to set, right? And therefore, you know, the flower setting, that's quite an involved metabolic process. And so there are definite nutrients that are needed during that time. Nitrogen is one. You have to be able to grow. Initially, fruit set and growth is primarily by cell division. So all the cells are dividing. Later in the growing season, it's by cell expansion. And so if you have a lot of cells set and divide early, right after bloom, then you have more cells that can expand later on. And so your fruit size is larger. Now we'll get into a whole bunch of reasons how to get that, but one of the things is nutrition. You need to have good nitrogen levels. The other thing that is important, really critical during pollination is boron levels. And so we need to have good levels of boron. And a lot of commercial growers will actually make applications of a boron fertilizer foliar application, either in the fall previous or just shortly after flowering. We'll try to get those flowers to set, actually do it before flowering so that the pollen tube will grow down and set and cause seed formation and will set the fruit. So that's the early part is nitrogen and then boron as well.
So, okay. So practically speaking, if I'm a backyard grower, I have done my first application in the late winter to prepare for the spring. How on earth do I add more nitrogen and boron to my trees starting from the spring? What do I add? Do I go to the garden center and say, hey, I'd like some nitrogen and boron for my trees, please?
Yeah. Some growers will throw on a foliar spray of nitrogen, but most of the time you've got enough that you did, if you did right in the spring, okay? Now the boron, this is going to sound, from the standpoint of homeowners, this is going to sound not crazy, but a tablespoon or two per gallon of 20 mule team borax. Remember the old washing powder and the old mule train the product? That'll give you your boron. Put that and spray that on your trees.
So you're mixing it with water, borax. Borax.
Boraxo. Yeah, Boraxo soap.
And I think it's available now at health food shops. I don't know. Is it? Where would you get borax?
Boraxo soap. There should be. That used to be, south of the Canadian border, that was a product that you could go in the grocery stores. It used to be an old soap, laundry soap product. I'm sure that some of the gardens have it.
Tell me about the fall. Should we be feeding our fruit trees in the fall?
Okay, we've gone through the season. We're harvesting the fruit. And all of a sudden, look up, there's a little, bit of what we call corking or bitter pit on our fruit, or it doesn't look right. A lot of time what commercial growers will do will be they will apply some of the micronutrients. And those micronutrients are such that they only require very small amounts. And those include things like boron. It includes manganese. It includes zinc. It includes iron. So a lot of times what commercial growers will do will be in the fall, after the fruit is off, but before the leaves drop, and while they're still green, they'll come in with a micronutrient spray. And again, maybe boron, and we talked about the 20 mule team borax that's still available in the grocery store, 1 to 2 tablespoons of that. Same thing, you can get an iron chelate material at your garden center, apply that. Zinc sulfate,